In this video, Attack of the Clones, we will be discussing the initiation of the adaptive immune response, which, unlike the innate response outlined in the previous video, takes longer to kick in, but is much more specific to the individual threats being encountered by the body. In our Star Wars system, a pocket of Imperial troops have unfortunately gone undetected from the earlier battle, and they've dug themselves into the reinforced defensive position of the Death Star. In immunological terms, the Death Star represents an area of persistent inflammation or infection that the innate immune system has not been able to deal with. These super battle droids have become battle-hardened, and as a result are going to be much tougher to destroy than their weaker droid counterparts. These super battle droids could represent bacteria that have become resistant to certain antibiotics, or pathogens that have found other ways to evade the innate immune system. The super battle droids wage war across the galaxy, which represents our body or the specific site of immune challenge, often leaving immense damage and destruction in their wake. The only option to rid the galaxy of these hostile invaders for good and restore balance is to call in the strength of the Jedi army, which represents the adaptive immune system. Fortunately for the Jedi army, Chewbacca and R2-D2 have been on a daring mission behind enemy lines, gathering intelligence on the new threat and bringing key information about these new droids to present to the Jedi commanders. Chewbacca and R2-D2 represent two types of cells called macrophages and dendritic cells. These cells are professional antigen-presenting cells and are able to educate the adaptive immune system about the nature of the threat being encountered. They do this by presenting small pieces of the threat in a molecule called MHC class 2 that they have on their surface, and they present this to other cells of the adaptive immune system. In Star Wars terms, think of this as R2-D2 presenting a holographic image of the super battle droid to help the young commanders of the Jedi army identify the threat they are about to encounter. These Jedi army commanders include Admiral Yularen, who represents a naive B lymphocyte, Princess Leia Organa, a naive CD4 T lymphocyte or helper T cell, and Luke Skywalker, a naive CD8 T lymphocyte or cytotoxic killer T cell. These cells are called naive because they have yet to encounter an immune threat, in a similar way that Leia and Skywalker, who is still new to his training in the ways of the Force, may be unsure how best to attack the super battle droid invader, having never seen one before. Fortunately, the immune system also has something called immune memory. These naive T and B lymphocytes, when they encounter a threat for the first time, can become long-lived memory cells that remember the threat they have encountered and are able to respond more quickly and efficiently. This is the basis of vaccination, where a version of the pathogen that cannot cause disease is introduced into the body to allow the naive immune system to learn about the specific threat. This is called the primary immune response. If the same threat is ever encountered again, the immune system mounts a secondary immune response, which is much more robust and helps eliminate the pathogen before it can cause any harm. The memory T cells in Star Wars can be represented by the Jedi Master's Yoda as a memory CD4 helper T cell. He takes on this role as he's not often directly involved in the battle itself, but instead directs the shots from behind the lines. And Obi-Wan Kenobi as a memory CD8 killer T-cell, who's often leading the charge to eliminate the dark side threat and restore balance to the Force. Our naive commanders, Leia and Luke, are able to consult with these wiser Jedi Masters to see if they have any insight from previous battles. Fortunately, Yoda and Obi-Wan have encountered a similar battle droid before and are able to offer advice and guidance to the younger, more naive counterparts on how best to attack this new threat. Armed with this new information from R2-D2 and the Jedi Masters, and backed by the might of the Jedi army, Luke and Leia begin to plan their assault. In the next episode of Immunology Wars, The Host Strikes Back, we will look at just how Luke and Leia carry out their attack to eliminate this threat and restore peace to the galaxy. Join us then for more Immunology Wars.